Today we're talking about how to disagree with your boss. Well, in this whiteboard session, we're actually going to talk about why disagreeing is not necessarily bad. We're also going to talk about how there are ineffective and effective ways to do it and some best practices. So first of all, why disagreeing is not bad. It actually can generate and stimulate some positive end results. So first of all, it can stimulate conversation, not only between you and your boss, but sometimes other team members. It can build trust and respect between you and your boss. They actually sometimes appreciate you bringing input or insights into the situation. It can also provide additional or new insights and new perspectives, prevent train wrecks possibly on a project or an initiative, and stop bad decisions. It can change course or switch gears on directions that they may be going. It can also inspire engagement from others. When people see you successfully disagree with the boss, it can provide an opening and a safe environment for others as well. It can also, but through this mechanism, generate new options and solutions, also synergy among the team, and serve as an icebreaker to open and shift the environment. So let's talk about disagreeing can generate, as we all know, tension, internal stress, sometimes chaos among the team or the environment. It can actually shut people down and can sometimes create hostility. So a best practice is, during the course of disagreeing, we've learned that it's not a good idea to disagree or during creative work sessions. Why is that? Because it's not a best practice to try to create and destroy at the same time. So when we look at ineffective and effective ways to disagree with your boss, let's first of all talk about some things that are ineffective. Arguing, maybe talking over each other, belittling, maybe blaming, and then just throwing in the kitchen sink. While we're talking about this, we're just going to pile on everything else that we, you know, want to put in there too. So what we found effective is to get an opening, you know, get an opening, ask some questions for your boss and see if they're even open to have input. So two good questions would be, are you open for other input or options? If they say no, you know, they may have reasons for decisions they make or routes they have, courses they have to go in. So you can also ask, have you thought about this or have you considered another option? That way you can gauge to see if they're open for discussion. Also, agree on the common solution or end result. What are we trying to solve here? If you think about what you're trying to solve, then you can discuss different options, different ways to get there. Then always speak with honor and respect to not only your boss, but other team members and people you may be arguing with as well. And then come to some kind of agreement. Sometimes we have to come to the agreement that we agree to disagree. So here are a few effective ways to disagree with your boss. And if you need additional resources or information, then visit our website at projectmanager.com.